Time to play with some clay. Well, I worked on the clay of the feet. I worked on the clay feet for the clay of Jesus last night until about, 11 o'clock. And got them pretty much done. I worked better at my computer table, because there was less stress, and I was able to listen to a book on YouTube, the Tom Clancy book I told you about yesterday. And here are some pictures I took last night. The first picture here shows the feet. I've got the left foot pretty well to the point where I can finish it off, and the right foot I'm just restarting, and it's about the third try on that foot. But I put it next to that foot. For the next picture, you can see I've got both feet together, and I was able to match the length of the toes and the pattern of the toes on both feet. It works a lot better when you can work on them separate and together. If you try to do it with a 1 foot 4 inches from the other foot, It's a lot harder to match the lengths and to match the foot. So the next picture shows you what I did. I went downstairs after I got done with the 2 feet, and I put them back onto the legs of the statue of Jesus, and they look great. They worked out fine. The next thing I need to do is to put the sandals on his feet next week, and that's what I'll do. But I just had to make a trip to Bozeman, and the following video I hope you'll enjoy.
Well, I'm going to Bozeman. I gotta get supplies for my kitchen and my office, and it's about a 50-mile trip, so see how it goes. Beautiful day for driving. It's not as windy now as it was last night, but last night I thought my house was going to be picked up and run away. Quick stop at the post office, and then I'm on my way. stop at the dump. We don't have trash pickup where I live, so we have to take it to the county dump or the city dump. Coming into Norris right now, this is an old community. Norris Hot Springs is just to the left, a little ways up the road. Keep going straight, I'd end up in Helena, but I don't want to go to Helena. That's the capital of Montana. I'm going to Bozeman. Fuel is $2.59 for regular right now, so that's not too bad, I guess. Bozeman Trail right now. It used to take 2 days for somebody to get to Bozeman by buckboard. When I first moved to Ennis, Montana back in 87, there were people living there that's the way they traveled to Bozeman back in the early part of the 1900s and latter part of the 1800s. And they told me it used to take 2 days to get to Bozeman. Now it takes about 45 minutes. We meet up with the Madison River. It's one of the three rivers that form the headwaters of the Missouri River, which is about 50 miles north of here. The Jefferson and the Gallatin and the Madison River all come together, and the Missouri River starts 50 miles north of here. I had a friend drive through this canyon right here some years ago and almost hit a damn mountain lion coming down for water. getting ready to cross the other of the three rivers, the Gallatin River, right there. And I'm almost to Bozeman now, and I'm gonna end the video here because I gotta make a few stops, and I don't want to bore you with all that. Well, I was going to stop at Costco, but I'm going to get home. The weather has changed drastically in just a half hour. So, I'm going to cut my trip to Bozeman short. Well, the snow stopped, but I'm still going to go home because it's a blizzard back behind me. You can see there's clear skies way out there in the west. And that's where our weather comes from. That was crazy, that storm. Wow. Just coming over the top of Norris Pass into the Madison Valley on the way home. It just, that storm kicked up so fast, I couldn't believe it. Of course, I should know by now that one minute it might be sunshine, the next minute it might rain or snow. That's Montana. Right at freezing right now. Good night, everybody, and I hope you have a great rest of the weekend. See you next week.
Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.